child of individualism searching for love. My generation is the generation of individualism. We're constantly aware of our profile, our image, and our character. Everybody's high level of self-awareness puts a lot of pressure on the individual to be a strong individual. And almost everybody I know have at some point said the phrase, to find myself. Let's just establish that self-realization is a common need for our generation without discussing the problems of self-realization as a concept. On top of that, we're the children of the divorced parents. I remember how, as a kid, divorce was not the norm. Through my teenage years, I've watched this change to the point where more married couples, in Denmark at least, ended up divorced than staying together. I think, without knowing shit, but hear me out, that these two phenomena combined have created this, us, the loveless generation. We're groomed and conditioned to think that the classical ideology of the nuclear family and, for better or for worse, are outdated and restrictive ways of thinking. You will not be able to practice self-realization if you're attached to someone and committed to someone. Because commitment and attachment means strengths, responsibilities, and burdens. Burdens, responsibilities, and strengths does not align with being young, independent, and a strong individual. As a young, progressive, outspoken feminist, the worst thing I could do is to let a man control my life and forget myself. However, guys, I think that this is bullshit. Something is neglected, forgotten, and misunderstood in this assumption. I need to, want to, and have to believe in my ability to be a strong individual. Sure. However, this perception of relationships, that commitment and attachment equal strengths, obligations, and burdens, is not aligned with my way of thinking. I need to, want to, and have to believe that everything I'm able to do alone, I'm able to do together with someone. If I can only have my principles, values, and interests when I'm alone, then I'm in fact not that strong of an individual. I'm actually impressionable. I also think that not being static and having the ability to change is extremely important. But this is about whether individualism is compatible with dualism or not. If I'm able to constructively and nuanced communicate the concept of myself and my partner the same, this problem of lost individuality should not occur. Actually, to me, relationships should not be strengths or burdens, but opportunity, possibility, and enlightenment. 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 Think about it. You break up with your stupid boyfriend to find yourself. What do? You party, you travel, you do new things. Why? Because being stuck with yourself will not help you to find yourself. You search for your individuality and your identity in the physical world. You depend on exterior things to impact you and help you discover something interior. But what is the most impacting, interesting, and communicative exterior thing you could find? A person. Another fucking human being. To me, the place where I really become aware of myself is not when I'm alone, but on the contrary, in the connection with other people. To me, the best thing for self-development and self-realization is not a lonely walk through the desert. It's to explore the mind with another human being. I'm not afraid of dualism. I would actually go so far as to say I long for it. This is hard for me to say. Because as earlier stated, I've been conditioned to believe that being a young, progressive, outspoken feminist is contradicting with wanting a relationship. So, I get lonely. Because we believe that the worst thing a young, progressive, outspoken feminist could do is fall in love. But I did. I fell in love. I believed in my ability to maintain my individuality and simultaneously loving another individual. And I wanted to commit. I was ready. Shit, I'm still ready. We found that we were both in positions where we needed to make decisions about life. He was currently without a job, apartment, and plans. In 5 months, I will too be without plans, apartment, and job. This forced us to address our still very young but intense relationship and the prospects of that. To me, it was obvious. I wanted us. I wanted him. I wanted to prioritize love. To me, he was an opportunity for adventures and enlightenment I couldn't achieve on my own. And I'm not saying that I couldn't achieve enlightenment or adventures on my own. But as earlier stated, another individual provides amazing opportunities for development. I was curious, and again, shit, I still am, about what we could evolve into together. Shit. It was a big shock for me to uncover these feelings and this state of mind, because a young, progressive, outspoken feminist doesn't care about no man. But I did, shit, I still do, care about this man more than care. And this is not about him or our relationship, but about the end of it. More than care, I love him. And he loves me. But he is indeed a young, progressive, outspoken feminist too. He is a child of individualism. He believes that a young, progressive, outspoken feminist needs self-realization. He finds himself in a position where he needs to make decisions about life. I offered myself as an option, but he declined. To him, self-realization is a lonely process. A relationship is burdens and strengths. I tried. We had beautiful conversations about being young, progressive, outspoken feminists. About being children of individualism, searching for love. And we agreed. But he could only tell me that I was right, that I was the mature one, and that he admired my perception. But he couldn't act on it. I suppose he wasn't ready to change his perception. I fell in love with a child of individualism, and I, a young, progressive, outspoken feminist, get lonely because we believe that the worst thing a young, progressive, outspoken feminist could do is fall in love.